Well, hello. This is my first official YouTube video for Star Wars Galaxy of Heroes. My name is Mike, and I am a real-life fruit ninja. If you don't know what that means, I have a nice little other video set up on YouTube right now, and you'll see what that means. What we've got here today is a pretty neat concept. We've got a full HAAT solo on auto. It's complete auto back front to back, and it's primarily with CLS here. There's another option with Jedi Training Raid that we'll show you in a little bit, this is the one that is truly a full auto moving forward. And so we're gonna go over the team, what modding requirements, if any, are really necessary, and what relic requirements are present, which are real. So there's a few reasons that the HAAT solo had on auto has been a little bit elusive. So it was present for a little bit a while ago, and they fixed a bug, and it ended up so that the turn meter wasn't quite as insane, so wasn't as easy to do. Now with the relics, we have some serious firepower that allows you to push through, and it doesn't matter if you have quite the same insane turn meter control, but you do have the damage that will do it. So a few things that are important about any full solo is you have to keep control of turn meter either by bonusing your turn meter or reducing the enemy turn meter, and this team does both of those things extremely well. Commander Luke Skywalker has been longtime favorite since he started. He was soloing the rancor raid by himself if he was well modded, and so that's really important. What we have is the 3PO, Commander Luke Skywalker, Hermit Yoda, Wampa, and Han. And each of these characters, I'll go through what they bring. You'll likely know for the most part, but we'll go over quickly what their kit brings to it. Commander Luke Skywalker is primarily here for the turn meter control, and both that is in his leadership ability, his IBAT unique Zeta ability, and his basic and his special. All of these things help with turn meter, both reducing the enemy turn meter for phases 1 and 3, and it helps with the gaining you turn meter for and your other units turn meter for phases 2 and 4. It's kind of a dichotomy there. Phases 1 and 3 are definitely much more important to deal with the opponent's turn meter because the health pool is not nearly as huge, both of those can get a ton of turns if you don't control it well. And the ways that you control that the best are absolutely Commander Luke Skywalker, C-3PO, and Han. And so those three are definitely the turn meter control units for that. The damage, pure damage, is just from Wampa and the additional damage per each unit with Master's Training on Hermit Yoda. Those are clearly the bonuses going on there. So Commander Luke, C-3PO, and Han all do turn meter control. Han does damage and turn meter control, but you'll see at the end that Han doesn't even come close to hitting the same as Wampa does as far as total damage done for the raid. So without further ado, we're going to start this off. I'm going to show you the basics, and we'll talk through what's going on. The first thing that we want to do is just make sure that Han ends up getting the first Master's Training, and then it's just total auto. So he's going to get that here, and that allows him to have extra potency, make sure that all the turn meter control lands on Grievous, and this is just full auto complete going from here. You can see that, and this is no surprise, there's been plenty of Commander Luke Skywalker based full auto teams for P1. This is not a surprise. The problem that we run into is P2, specifically for the Commander Luke Skywalker. He just hasn't had enough damage per second to kill off the P2, the tank that has the most health out of everything. And so what we see see here is Grievous is taking a few turns, and he will get a few bonus turns from him getting hit, but it doesn't matter because 3PO's buff immunity for the Confuse and CLS's buff immunity, just the flat buff immunity, are just making it impossible for him to take a chain of turns in a row. So that's all that's really important, and it's quite clear that we're dealing a crap ton of damage, and we'll see what Wampa does here a few times, because it gets pretty nuts. 69,000 for, and he doesn't even have Master's Training yet for his AoE, and we're doing 100 and some thousand, 120, 130,000 from his basic. This is an R7 Wampa. That, I think, is legitimately required to get through P2 without any hiccups. And having a high relic Han doesn't hurt as well. He's R5 for me here. CLS is R1, so not too big. But Wampa, 160,000, jeez. So we'll just walk through this a little bit, just speed it up, because we're almost done with this phase, and it's only been, like, what, a minute or two? Yeah, 2 minutes, and yeah, he's only at 10, so for the enraged timer. So this clearly, no surprise that we're able to wreck P1 with Commander Luke Skywalker team. It's this part that gets really interesting. So the problem with this phase in the past has been you don't always know where your units are going to target, and if they hit the main tank too many times, the tank will get too many turns, and so you can't end up autoing it. The bonus that Wampa, and before more than any other unit, provides is the ability to simply AoE the tank every single time, except for that first one where he isn't quite charged up. Every single time that he hits his AoE from now on, he is going to topple the tank completely. And his kit makes it so that he will do the AoE pretty much only when there's multiple units around to hit. So it makes a big difference, and we're going to gain some turn meter here for Commander Luke, and Wampa gains turn meter every time that he hits, and because he hits anything, and if he is not debuffed, then he gains 20% turn meter. If the opponent that he's hitting is debuffed, he gains an additional 20% turn meter. So potentially for every single time that he hits, he gains 40% turn meter. You can see that going on the clock there, that he gains 40% turn meter each time he hits, and then that just ramps up his damage every single time, makes it so that it's really hard for the tank to keep up. And so we are just chewing through the tank here at the beginning. So we'll just push through a little bit and see towards the end of phase to and see what kind of crazy damage that he's doing that allows you to continue doing this. So we're just going to move through. Wampa's doing damage. We're getting some enraged timer going down. Still in a comfortable spot, but it's there. And so now we'll start it up again when Wampa's really starting to get cranked up, and where it really starts to be important. And he gained turn meter there, gains turn meter there. He just gains so much turn meter, it's obscene. And then, bam, that was what was the important part there is, yeah, we only targeted the main tank, but because Wampa gains so much turn meter and takes so many turns in a row, he is just going to topple the tank 95% of the time before it goes. And when that happens, it combined with the amount of insane damage that he's about to do here, I think he does 400-some towards the end of the tank sometimes. Maybe that was more in the JTR video that I'll show you in a bit. But anyways, what we got with the Wampa here, he's doing an insane amount of damage. The enrage timer is at 1. Even if it goes off to 0, it's fine. You can get one pass topple without much issue. So, but again, he topples immediately with his AoE. That is absolutely the most important part of this solo, and bar none, that makes it that is the most important section of the solo, because this section is the most difficult to solo on auto. I've not touched anything here. If you've seen the green auto button is on the entire time. This phase is a complete joke versus Commander Luke or Skywalker, so I'm just going to push through it a little bit, because he just controls the turn meter too well. And we even have horrible targeting at the start of this. And we didn't. We haven't targeted the main B2 yet, the Super B2, and we're still just completely in charge. And so turn meter starts taking control, and this is the end, the beginning of the end, because the confuse, that confuse there, that makes it so that he counters a lot less, and because of that, you're just not going to get into trouble versus this. And a lot of these are assists anyways, from both C-3PO and Herman Yoda, so you're just not going to run into problems. And the turn meter control on this with Commander Luke and Han Solo, those two could solo this phase by themselves, honestly, if they wanted to. So we're just going to push through this. This is not an important phase. You'll see that at the end, he's still at 13 in rage timer, and that is not surprising at all. And honestly, the next phase is not that much different than phase two. It's just honestly a little bit easier as long as you can keep buffs up. And a few different units will keep buffs up for you. It's C-3PO, Hermit Yoda, and Han also keep buffs up for you, and Wampa keeps his own buff up. So that is a really simple thing, but we're just going to watch here briefly when we start out, and I'm not targeting anything. This is all on auto, you can see. And Wampa hits that, he dazes. You don't even hit everything right out the bat because he hasn't ramped up his damage yet. But yeah, Han, or Han's gonna counter there, and he's gonna nail it. No targeting by me whatsoever there. And Wampa is just gonna start going to town. And this has a lot less health pool than phase two, and it's a very similar thing as long as you do not die from the insta kill, which means you need to have at least a buff on each character every time the tank untopples, you're just totally fine. So again, we're just going to roll through this, but Wampa starts doing some bonkers type damage towards the end. We'll watch him again here, hopefully do the tank topple by himself. I guess Han took it that time, but it wouldn't have mattered if he didn't because we're only at 13 in rage timer and it's 50% gone already. So phase four has never been the difficulty. Phase four was the first phase to be soloed in this raid, so it really is not the difficult part. So we're just going to push through here, and you can see that we're about 15 minutes in, and this is just a complete auto solo. If you want to save your time and you still want to get the tank rewards, this is what you're going to do going forward. There's a few other possibilities now, I'm sure, since we've gotten the relic levels out for different characters, but that's it. And I didn't post the damage on that because I wanted to record a different one, and we'll show you that quickly here as well. So we have the JTR version here, and JTR has a little more trouble with phase one. And the reason for that is JTR does not have quite as good turn meter control as Han does and CLS. And there's certainly some thought about, who exactly you want in this team. There certainly could be some comps that you end up using those units on. But for this one that I've done, it's not quite a full solo. I haven't been able to test it completely, but I'm sure it's out there to use a JTR version as well. The bonus that JTR gives you isn't in P1, it's in P2, because P2 is just super simple with JTR. And so we're gonna run through this. Essentially, we're just not trying to not get Grievous too angry, only hit him for really big shots, avoid having Jedi Training Ray and BB-8 hit him if possible. Of course, he's gonna counter there, but that's not the end of the world. But once we get down to about 60%, and Grievous hasn't been pissed off too much, you can see I'm not targeting him. That's where this gets involved. In the testing that I did, maybe 50-50, you could solo this if you just threw it on auto right away, and the other 50% of the time, Grievous got enraged too far past the timer. You can probably survive one enrage, but not two. So, and Grievous definitely takes a lot of turn that way. So we're just targeting other things until we get BB-8's Illuminated Destiny off, and then get a few Wampa Roars, get everybody Hermit Yoda'd up, and then at that point you can totally auto it. So we're just going to push forward a little bit. We get to about 60% here, and we're still at 10% or 10 in rage timer, so we're looking pretty good in that department. And everybody has the Illuminated Destiny buff up, so we are going to be doing a lot of damage here. So this is the point where we start saying, you know what, this is fine, and we're just going to throw it on auto very shortly here, I believe. But you can see that we started doing that and getting the damage in a little bit further, but we're just still targeting things other than General Grievous specifically for this part. And then now we're at 46%, 9, 42%. You can see how huge a chunks that Wampa's taking out. And yeah, now that at this point I threw it on auto, right around 50%. So it takes a few minutes, but it's not anywhere near what you would need. You used to need to constantly be checking in, making sure that you're toppling correctly on phase two. That's where this one really excels. So we'll push through this now. This is just total DPS by Wampa, and Wampa starts doing insane amounts of damage. At the end of not necessarily this phase, but at the end of at the end of phase two, it is truly bonkers. He's doing 113,000 AoE there. But yeah, this is just a really sweet counter that I am really excited about, and this should be it for that. Yep, there goes Grievous. Bye, buddy. And we get to phase two, and again, this is the super cool part is Wampa is just destroying things. He's already doing 140,000, and I did not target those. He just decided to target them that way. It wouldn't have mattered because you're going to have a number of enrage timer at the end of this, and it would have been fine if it would have waited for his AoE to totally wreck that. Everybody's seen this kind of thing before where Jedi training Rey, and they usually use Finn, but Finn obviously doesn't have that AoE, so you can get screwed by your RNG factors if that doesn't get targeted consistently. So move forward a little bit. Wampa's doing damage, doing damage, doing damage, and all of a sudden Wampa starts going insane. And I'll show you what we mean here. 445,000 per shot at the end. We're at 9 enrage, and there's only 17% left. This has been on complete auto. And yeah, so Wampa is going to continue to do 450,000 damage every single time he hits the tank, and that equates to like 3% of the tank every time he hits. So there's just no way that the tank can keep up with that. Which is pretty sweet. So hopefully we'll have Wampa do an AoE here so we can show you how powerful that is at this point. Bam! Over 200,000 on the AoE. No chance for the tank to survive through that. And that is just bonkers. And the same thing goes for P3 and P4. You know, it's P3, you need a little bit more turn meter control, but it has been easily autoable for some time. It's really the combination of being able to auto P1 and P2 at the same time, because those are the phases that are completely different. P1 is all about turn meter control of Grievous. P2 is all about turn meter control of you and keeping turn meter control, giving yourself bonuses while the tank is toppled. And that's what the JTR comp does better than the C-Last version. So if you don't have a fully relicked Wampa and Raid Han, then you might want to use this version. I think this can work even at a lower Wampa relic, but the other one I do not believe would because you don't have the DPS present to be able to get through some of the zones. Not 3 and 4, but 1 and 2 could get a little sketchy if you don't have a full relicked Wampa. So we're just gonna push through here again and moving through, moving through. We'll see what kind of insanity Wampa does at the end here, because it truly is just bonkers. And it doesn't matter who they target, eventually Wampa's just gonna kill all of them. Obviously, it's stupid to try and attack the little B1s, but it just doesn't matter because you'd end up doing 180,000 AoE and Illuminated Destiny. And so we're just gonna push through here again. And we'll get you the damage count on the end of this because this isn't too important. This section we've shown you a few times, and as I mentioned, Wampa just AoEs everything, and so the B2s do not matter. When the Tompa come, when the tank comes up, he just nails them, and he has like extra tenacity both from his protection up from his kit, and then from master's training from Yoda, and so between those two things, he is not getting ability blocked by the B2 troopers. So it just does not matter if we end up hitting this a bunch because the health pool is just not there. And bam, 150,000 AoE. That is what, more than anything, that's what allows this comp to work extremely well. and he's doing 350 again. And yeah, we'll just bring it up to the end, and we have the final hits at almost 400,000, 396,000 for Wampa. And what we have here at the end, we'll go through. We have a good old victory sign, and we'll check out the damage. Every time I've done this, it's been the same. Wampa has gotten between 36 and 37 million, and these two are around like 8 and around 2, somewhere in that range. And it is very consistent. Once you get through 50% of phase 1, you can just throw it on auto. If you have a little bit less relic with your Wampa, then this is the way to go. I don't know exactly what the low limit is. You probably need a gear 13, you know, a few relic Wampa to make sure, because his gear 13 piece made a huge difference in his damage. Same for Raidhan. I don't think that you can do the other one with without a relic Raidhan and relic Wampa. So that's it for today. Thanks for stopping by and watching, and I'll have some more fun with Wampa out in the near future. We're going to explore what HAAT and Wampa can do together. Thanks for stopping by. Love you guys, and hit me up with a like and subscribe, everything, and we'll move on from there. Thanks, bye.